Reddy Memorial Trust. And also I welcome all the participants once again. Now I request all the dignitaries on the dais kindly proceed for the floral tributes to Professor G. Ram Reddy Gari portrait.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, madam. We acknowledge in this webinar Mrs. Ram Reddy Garu Pramila Madam, I also joined, and former Vice Chancellor Professor V.S. Prasad Garu. Many other directors, deans, and heads of the branches are also joined in this webinar. I once again welcome you all. Now I request Professor K. Sitarama Rao Garu, President of the today's program, kindly to conduct the further proceedings. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Dr. Venugopal Reddy, PRO of our university, and I extend a warm welcome on behalf of our university and on behalf of me also. Now I request Dr. A.V.N. Reddy, in charge registrar of our university, to give a formal welcome address to the guests who are there in this program today.
Thank you, sir. Warm welcome to today's program of Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture, organizing by the Dr. B. R. Ambedkar Open University and Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust. I grateful to the Vice Chancellor, Professor K. Sitarama Rao Garu, for presiding this function today, and guest speaker, Professor Vinay Kumar Pathakji, Vice Chancellor CAJ, MU, Kanpur. And also, I have to welcome to Professor G. Harugopal Garu, who is almost all contemporary colleague of Ram Reddy Garu, I think so, that's junior, sir, maybe, teacher of mine also. is secretary of Ram Reddy Memorial Trust, director academic Professor Sudharani Garu, and who are joining this program, G. Pramila Ram Reddy Garu and other family members of Ram Reddy Garu, Professor V. S. Prasad sir, former vice chancellor of the Ambedkar Open Institute, not director, former director, and other dignitaries who are watching through Zoom platform. So technology enabled education in next generation is the right topic at present situation, sir. Almost all after post pandemic and pandemic situations, so without technology there is no movement of any individuals or society in the world. Particularly in education field, every move is almost all going to towards technology enabled activities. So particularly open universities are very much need and awake and aware about the technology enabled education. Anyhow, a warm welcome to the today program, and I request the vice chancellor to conduct further proceedings. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. A.V.N. Reddy. Today's chief guest and main speaker, who is giving Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Endowment Lecture, Professor Vinay Kumar Pathak, Vice Chancellor, Chhatrapati Shivaji University, Kanpur. Shahuji Maharaj, Chhatrapati Shahuji Maharaj University, Kanpur, and this lecture, you know, we are organizing since more than 5 years in collaboration with Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust. Respected Professor G. Haragopal sir, Secretary of Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust, Professor Sudharani, Director Academic, and also other honorable online lecture program, especially our most respectable teacher, Professor V.S. Prasad, former Vice Chancellor of this university, and also former NAC Director, and Srimati Pramila Ram Reddy Garu, who kindly accepted our invitation and joined in this program to online, and other office bearers and members of the Professor Ram Reddy Memorial Trust, and colleagues of Ambedkar Open University, employees, students, research scholars, and all the who are well-wishers of this university, and also fans of Professor Ram Reddy. We are celebrating today's lecture program in the context of 92nd birth anniversary of Professor G. Ram Reddy, who is a great educationist and founder vice chancellor of this university, really who made a lot of impact on the higher education system in India. After establishing first open university here at Hyderabad, through the legislative act of the then AP government, and he was invited to New Delhi to establish National Open University that is Indira Gandhi National Open University in 1985. So, as the first Open University of India, and people of the country, even everybody, especially we always remember and respect the role played by the Professor G. Ramareddy in taking forward and also democratizing the higher education in our country. There is no doubt he is the person who grown the higher education from the ivory towers to the common man. And he is the first person to evolve a policy reaching the unreached through the education system and made many people who could not continue their higher education because of various restrictions and reasons, maybe various problems of their personal and all that. So today's topic of memorial lecture is on technology enabled education in the next generation. This is most contextual and also a very important topic to be deliberated for a person like Professor Vinay Pathak, who is having a lot of experience in the use of IT in the field of education and also integrating latest information and communication technology methods in the higher education system as a whole. We thought that he is the right person. Our choice is most suitable to select Professor Vinay Kumar Pathakji to deliver this Professor G. Ramareddy Memorial Endowment Lecture today. And this, the context is also very important because the National Education Policy 2020 also emphasized on the extensive use of technology and integrating technology in the higher education or education as a whole. And it also emphasized on online and digital education and also quality of ODL and online education. So it has emphasized on many aspects like blended mode of learning, multimedia and multimode methods, and also ensuring equitable use of information and communication technology, transforming the regulatory system, and also mostly emphasizing on the blended mode of learning, that is multi mode of learning, through learner-centric approach and methods in the process of teaching, learning, research, and evaluation. So I feel this is the right context we are discussing and deliberating on the technology-enabled learning for the next generation. So the learner-centric city is also a very important dimension of education system as a whole. Whether it is face-to-face learning or ODL learning or online learning, these three modes of learning and teaching has been recognized by the National Education Policy. The learner centricity means that availability of multiple entry and exit points, promotion of mother tongue and other languages, focus on the arts and humanities, reforming the examination system with open book testing and group exams, ready support for mature learners, and also various factors in the potential of time, place, mode, speed, and language, that in many ways, is going to be the new approach of education. So this new concept needs to be adopted by the any higher learning institution in India in the context of national education policy to go forward in expanding the base of higher education in our society and making the society more aware of the society and also our human relations as a whole. So with this brief introduction or presidential remarks, whatever you wanted to say, I request Professor Sudharani to introduce the speaker, chief guest today, in a brief manner. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Respected Vice Chancellor, Professor Sitaram Rao Garu, and the guest, chief guest of today's Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture, Professor Vinay Pathak, sir, and the Ambedkar Memorial Trust Secretary, Hargopal, sir, and Srimati Pramila Ram Reddy Garu, and the family members of Professor G. Ram Reddy, and the members of the Ambedkar Memorial Trust, the Ram Reddy Memorial Trust, and Registrar Avian Reddy, and our directors, deans, and my faculty, and all the fraternity of Dr. BRAVOU. Very good morning to you all. It's a privilege to introduce the theme, technology-enabled education in next generation, which is the theme of the today's memorial lecture. And also, Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture, we have been celebrating since 2016 in our campus, in collaboration with the Ram Reddy Memorial Trust. The endowment lectures, so far we have conducted 4 lectures and this is the 5th one in nature. We started in 2016 with Dr. Ranjan Velukar, who spoke on landscape of higher education in 21st century. And the second lecture is Dr. Vaidyanath Iyer in 2017, contribution of Professor G. Ram Reddy to higher education. And the third lecture, Professor Farkan Khamar, regulatory reforms in higher education. And the fourth one is delivered by D. Narasimha Reddy Garu on challenges of higher education. This is a fifth endowment lecture, and which is aptly selected by the topic that future technologies for future learning. And Professor G. Ram Reddy, the doyen of higher education, and who always considered Open University the temples of higher learning. And he is a person who democratized the higher education to the marginalized sections and perceived the higher education fruits to be given to the marginalized, to the last section of the society. And with the founder, Vice Chancellor of Ambedkar Open University, as well as IGNOU and 12th Vice Chancellor of Usmani University, and the founder of several other institutions. His ideals and ideas in democratizing higher education is a like a torch to our initiatives we have incorporated in our mission and vision, the document, the democratization of higher education. And we are very fortunate to have his guidance for our Ambedkar Open University. And I'm very glad to introduce, it's my privilege to introduce Professor Vinay Kumar Pathak, sir, who was born in 1969, but who has spent nearly upward of 30 years in the technological inventions. And Pathak, sir, has a bright academic career as lecturer, assistant professor, HBTA Kanpur, project scientist, IIT Kanpur, and again as professor and dean of HBTA Kanpur, and taking over as a vice chancellor on 25th November 2009 and OUH. Dr. Pathak did his BTech in computer science from the Harcourt Butler Technological Institute, Kanpur, 1991, MTech from IIT Kharagpur in 98, and PhD from Computer Science in UP Technological University, Lucknow, And research interest of Patek sir is computational geometry and image processing. Dr. Patek has been instrumental in implementation of Vedic mathematics in 1992. He worked in Media Lab Asia successfully and he worked with the Intel Corp and attended many national international conferences both in the country and abroad, including France, Poland, USA, Portugal, Hungary, Morocco, Korea, China, Macau, Singapore, Egypt, and several of his papers presented have been acclaimed national international levels. And Dr. Patek has taught several courses in the field of computer sciences and organized several symposias also. And he published nearly 38 articles in reputed journals and 10 PhDs awarded his able guideship. Has rich academic and administrative experience as vice chancellor for 4 universities, including the present, and hold additional charges for 4 more universities. And the Chhatrapati Sahuji Maharaj University, Kanpur, and APJ Abdul Kalam University, Technological University, Vardhaman Mahavir Open University, Uttarakhand Open University, and additional charges for 4 more universities. He has rich administrative experience and he's instrumental in implementation of NEP, technological interventions and digitization, quality enhancements, research development, infrastructure and development, and social welfare rehabilitation. So this seamless hybrid education is his contribution, and the access, content, and empower of the technological interventions to the higher education. And the future is a one nation and one campus is going to be the future, anytime, anywhere education. So especially due to this pandemic, the technological interventions have been more, and the lecture of Dr. Patek is going to eliminate us in this, the technology interventions for the future generation. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity. Sir.
Thank you very much, Professor Sudharani, for your elaborate introduction of the chief guest of the day. And chief guest is a very nice person, and I happen to work along with him in the peer team of Indira Gandhi National Open University NAC peer team. Still I remember, and he way he worked in that team. So sir, once again I extend a warm welcome. The next item on the agenda is I request respected Professor G. Hargopal, Secretary, Professor G. Ramreddy Memorial Trust, to give his message on this occasion. Thank you, sir.
Professor Sitaram Rao, the Vice Chancellor of B.R. Ambedkar Open University, Professor Vinay Kumar Patakji, the chief guest of today's function, Professor V.S. Prasad, a very close friend of mine, and he was also Vice Chancellor of Ambedkar Open University, then Director of NAC, and other colleagues and friends. I extend a welcome to Vinay Kumar Patakji for delivering this Professor Ramreddy Memorial Lecture. As Sudharani ji said, that this is the 5th lecture to be delivered by Patak ji. To say briefly about Professor G. Ramreddy Memorial Trust, as Professor Sitaram Rao said, that contribution of Professor G. Ramreddy has been very immense, very rich to higher education in post-independent India. He was Vice Chancellor of Usman University at a very young age. And then, of course, when he was the Vice Chancellor, since I was working with him in a project, he was toying with this idea of how to, enable or explore the possibility of a marriage between technology and growing needs of education. And it is from this idea, from this churning that was going on in his mind, that this idea of open university emerged. Although earlier the Government of India appointed a committee, the idea was in the air, but it was Professor Ram Reddy who brought it onto the ground and set this university, and therefore Ambedkar Open University is one of the first university in India, and he has built it, and because of his imaginative ideas and building this university, Government of India requested him to build the Indira Gandhi National Open University. Now I think when you go to Indira Gandhi National Open University, you see how it has enlarged. It's unbelievable, expansion of Indira Gandhi National Open University. So is the case with the Open University, Ambedkar Open University. Then there are several open universities in this country. I think this is one of the rich contribution, and that's why Professor Ram Reddy is treated as a father figure of distance education in India. He was a liberal democrat, and he was very humane, and he had larger social concerns. And Professor Ram Reddy held the highest position of being the chairman of University Grants Commission, and he was actually vice president of the Commonwealth of Learning, and he was invited by the then government to head the University Grants Commission. Later, he became chairman of ICSSR. I think there are very few academics in post-independent India who held so many positions to guide the social science research, to guide the higher education, and also, expansion of distance education. A person who contributed in such a rich way needs to be remembered, because every generation benefits from the contributions and memory of previous generation, because every generation has to stand on the shoulders of the previous generation. And remembering people, recalling their memory is extremely important for a society to progress in civilizational terms. So therefore, Professor Ram Reddy, because he was a man of exceptional integrity and upheld very high principles in personal life, I think these are the values which need to be upheld by every generation, because that's how the culture and civilization of a society grow. And with that the Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust was set. Of course, the members were very distinguished personalities of this country. Professor C.H. Hanumant Rao, the former Planning Commission member and a very renowned economist who was very close to Professor Ram Reddy, because they were class fellows from their school days. And that association continued all through life. And Professor C.H. Hanumant Rao very gracefully agreed to be the chairman of the trust. And some of us who are students of Professor Ram Reddy have accepted certain, responsibilities. And Professor V.S. Prasad was a sort of moving force. I mean, he has been the one without whose support it would have been very difficult to run the trust. When you have very distinguished people, they contribute to the reputation of the trust. But running of a trust depends upon younger people who can run around. And I think somewhere Professor Ram Reddy Memorial Trust could not do what it is expected of such a trust in the name of such a distinguished person. I personally have been confessing year after year that we have perhaps not been able to do justice to Professor Ram Reddy's Memorial Trust. Nevertheless, we organized memorial lectures, endowment lectures, and we invited very distinguished people of the country. Whomever we have requested, ever said no to give the memorial lecture, because the respect that Professor Ram Reddy commanded. Then at a later stage, we thought that we should institute an award in the name of Professor Ram Reddy to a young social scientist. so that it works as an incentive for young social scientists with the inspiration of Professor Amreddy to do work and to work on the frontier areas of social science research. This award is given in the areas which were close to the heart of Professor Amreddy. One is public policy, because he was one of the first professors in the Usman University as a professor of political science to conceive the idea that public policy should become one of the important areas of research in political science. And then, of course, his own area was Panchayat Raj. Some of us, myself, Professor Prasad, and several other scholars, we have all worked on Panchayat Raj for our doctoral degrees, partly inspired by him. And we all thought that grassroots democracy is very important. And he is a pioneer of research in grassroots democracy and Panchayat Raj. And of course, in distance education, as he is the father of the distance education. So any scholar making a valuable contribution to any one of these areas is awarded this degree, Professor Amreddy Memorial Award every 2 years. It's a biannual award. And I'm happy to report that whoever was awarded, they have done immense work, and very young scholars, and they continue to work in those areas. Only last 2 years, we could not award this, we could not give this award to any scholar because of pandemic. Pandemic disrupted the entire life of the world, not only of India, and several activities were withheld, or they could not proceed. I think it has put the clock back. The pandemic definitely has put the clock back. We only hope that we will soon be liberated from this, and we will renew our activity, and promise that we'll continue our effort. And today's lecture, the trust also appreciates, because this is also close to Professor G. Ram Reddy's heart, that technology, and as I said in the beginning, that he was the one who was trying to explore the possibility of a happy marriage between growing demands and education, and the growing demands of education, the expansion of technology. But as a word of caution, I would say that during the pandemic period, we have seen the extreme limitations of technology. Technology has efficiency dimension because it multiplies human capacity, but technology also has a limitation because it normally tends to centralize the power, because it also has authority built into itself. Because technology leads to authoritarianism, technology leads to liberation. Now, for what purpose technology used is extremely important. As far as accessibility to technology is concerned, I'm sure Professor Pathanji will touch that it has widened the inequalities in education. At one stage, it has provided access, but technology is not accessible to all, particularly rural India. One of the surveys says only 20% of Indians have access to this technology. And one of the surveys conducted by People's Union for Civil Liberties in Bombay slums, they came out with a finding that only 0.8% of the children in Bombay slums have access to this. So how to overcome this serious constraint on technology is also very important. I used to discuss with Professor Amreddy that this inadequate accessibility to the larger sections of the society, how does it overcome? I may also add that Professor Eshpal, who gave one of the memorial lectures, a very distinguished scientist of this country, in fact, in his lecture, he emphasized that person-to-person interaction, eye-to-eye interaction, has no substitute. He said, whatever may be the technological expansion, ultimately essence of human life lies in the personal interaction, personal interface, sitting with each other, talking, a teacher talking to the students in a physical mode, I think is still, I think, one of the best forms of exchange of knowledge, provoking new ideas, and pushing the frontiers of knowledge forward. I mean, this, of course, has been experienced, but notwithstanding the limitation, the importance of technology cannot be emphasized, underemphasized. And Professor Amreddy was continuously arguing that technology has to expand. It has become, because he had larger concern. But how the technology expands, I think, is one question that needs to be adequately addressed, so that the marginalized sections of this country will have access. And in that sense, this lecture by Professor Pathakji is very important, partly because of its contextual importance, as Professor Sitaram Rao said, and partly because it's very close to the heart of Professor Amreddy. And on behalf of the trust, once again, I welcome Professor Pathakji and thank him for accepting the invitation to deliver this very important lecture. Yeah. Thank you, Sitaram Rao.
Thank you very much, sir, for your brief explanation about the trust activities and also your memories, Professor G. Ramreddy. Since we have worked with him very closely in his academic life. We do agree with you. We cannot undermine the role of technology, and at the same time, we cannot ignore the personal interaction pushing forward the boundaries of knowledge. So, you also said that the topic of today's lecture is not only contextual, and it is close to the heart of Professor G. Ramreddy. It's also very important, sir. And Professor Ramreddy used to say, the open universities are temples of learning. And he's of the opinion that the stands and open education system is only the approach. Now, online education also. Only the approach can meet the challenge of educational problems in the developing countries or third world countries, whatever it is. So this opinion counts a lot. That is the reason it would make a lot of impact on the expansion of democratizing the higher education in our country. So now I request our chief guest and main speaker of today's program, Professor Vinay Kumar Pathakji, to deliver Professor Ramreddy Memorial Endowment Lecture. Thank you, sir. I welcome you once again to deliver this lecture.
Good noon to all of you. Is my voice is audible, please?
Audible, okay, sir. We are able to hear you.
Am I able to share? Can you see the PowerPoint? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, Honorable Vice Chancellor of the University, I have also worked with him. And the persons from the trust of G.V. Ramreddy Saab. It's really a pleasure to give a Ramreddy Memorial Lecture in a prestigious university that's an open university of Andhra Pradesh. I remember those days when I was working in VMOU Kota, and I went there I visited Hyderabad and seen the one of the oldest university in the open and distance learning. I think all of us have said more about Professor Ramreddy. Professor V.S. Prasad is also there. So my wishes and my request to him also that he has also given a lot of blessings to me. I think today, at the outset of the fourth industrial revolution, we are having this lecture of Ramreddy Memorial Lecture. where we will be talking about the emerging technologies in education. I think it's a next 10 years, we are going to visit the highest disruption in the world. Although the distance and open learning university, Professor Ram Reddy was known as one of father of open and distance learning university. I think with the technologies, things have totally changed. And the disruptions have also made us in a very, very new direction. The fourth industrial revolution where man and machine is going to be one will witness a lot of changes in the education and other fields. I think we are witnessing, this is a kind of a generation which has visited and which has witnessed COVID, which was actually a kind of a rarest virus kind of thing after 100 years. But this generation is also visiting a lot of changes. Change in the sense that from the first industrial revolution of steam engine and second of electricity and third of radio waves, we have come to a fourth industrial revolution where man and machine is going to be one. And that disruption we are also going to witness in another 10 years, the kind of the thing which was ruling the world, like IC engines, is going to be at one end and we will be having electrical engines. We are having a lot of apps, we are having a lot of startups, we are having a lot of innovations, we are having a lot of IT enabled households, artificial intelligence, data science, machine learning, blockchain, cryptocurrency, is all going to rule the world for another how many years, we actually don't know. So let me share some points, some ideas. It's a really memorable for me to present at a memorial lecture of such a person of the highest dignity. So my good wishes to this trust also, and also with his blessings, we can start this lecture. Next slide, please. So one of the most important aspects of technology in education is the ability to level the field of opportunity for the student. I think, to my best of knowledge, technology is one of the great social equalizers. And in the country, when the open and distance learning started, we remember that we had talked about that elusive triangle of access, equity, triangle and equality. So access is still one of the things which we are looking for. And this access, the technology has given the access, and it is actually a social equalizer, which is going to make a people as one. So the opportunity for students really goes. Next, please. So whatever the table of contents, we have said the education, the future, emerging technologies, discussion, and the conclusion. This is what we are going to have in this lecture. Next, please. So let us go education, how it's evolving. We'll show some slides and see some slides, please. Okay, go to the next slide, please. Yes. So if you look to the 1900 to 1920, there was a one room schoolhouse kind of a thing. 1923, the classroom began incorporating radios. Next, please. 1930, we have got overhead projector initially used for US military training, quickly spread to the schools. 1933, 52% of school are using silent films and 3% are using films with sound. I think we remember our student days where we also have seen the silent films and the movies, which is there. Next, please. 1939, the first TV appears in a classroom. So we have seen this TV. Actually, we have also seen in nowadays. 1960, headphones become popular in school language. In our country, it came slightly. 1980, whiteboards are invented to replace the chalkboards. So we have seen the whiteboards. 1984, basic language is developed, and I have also used that. Dartmouth College, with the intent of giving a student a simple programming language that's easy to learn. 1986, touch typing of where movies, Beacon Teaching Typing is developed and popular school. 84, Apple Macintosh computer is introduced. The ratio of, this is 94, this is computer and students in US school is I-92. So this Apple Mac, 88 laptops are introduced and are eventually utilized as teaching tools. 90, CD-ROM became a prominent form of the storage. So we can see that what is there, 1991, 2002. Now we have got 2013, 2012. So we have got mobile handheld devices and all these devices for all these technologies. So this was really a journey for all of us, the technology, how the technology has been integrated. We have moved from computer-assisted instructions to the instructions where we can go and see that what kind of new things with all the artificial intelligence and machine learning is there. So this is one of the journey, a rudimentary journey, which we can really look upon for this kind of things. Next, please. So if we look at this slide, it's an important slide. Learning education technology brief. You can always say principle number one, can be used tool for learning. Second, technology should be used to increase access to learning opportunity for all children. Guiding principle three to my mind, technology may strengthen relationship among parents, family, early educators, and young children. Guiding principle three is very, very important because often miss this kind of principle where we cannot have peer learning. Technology four is the more effective for learning when adults and peers interact and cope with young children. Next, please. If you look at the advantages, you see the slide is technology can help and organize learning around more challenges. And this is one of the important thing, and I really want to say, if you look to the COVID, the brick and mortar structures were not working. And although the open and distance learning, we were never after the brick and mortar structure, but the project-based learning we used to do, even the labs and the simulation we used about this, so digital learning devices, resources to show competence with complex concepts and content. Technology can enable personalized learning or experiences that are more engaging and relevant. So these are the technologies which we can really say that's an important time which technology can see the personalized learning or experience that are engaging. And in the country, I always used to say very happily that there were gurukuls in this country where we were having personalized learning. And similarly, the technology is one thing which is also now giving a personalized learning. So we don't need people who can teach in the industry kind of an environment, but personalized learning, one-to-one peer learning can happen, and this can happen in the technology as we were doing in the Gurukuls for a long time. Next, please. Post-COVID although we lost many peoples, our many relatives in this COVID, and I think at this time, but we also learned a lot. And I think post-COVID era has also put a strength that what is our traditions, we have to follow it. So our humanity and planet are under threat. The pandemic has only served to prove our fragility and our interconnectedness. Urgent action taken together is needed to change the course and reimagine our futures. That's what UNESCO has written. And I think the post-COVID era has also told us to relook to our education in terms of the technology and other kind of things. So that has given us an insight. Next, please. So that is what post-COVID we have to think about. Strengthening education as a common good, right to education, value the teaching profession and teachers' collaboration. It's a very, very important point that in this post-COVID and the COVID kind of a thing, we have really gone into a thing that teachers' collaboration are needed. And we actually did a lot of online activities and a lot of new collaboration has happened. Although our universities were closed, but I think with this online kind of a thing, we collaborated a lot. Student, youth, and children, participation and rights, social spaces provided by the schools, free and open source technology. FOSS was one important thing which we should make just to available to teachers and sources. Scientific literacy with the curriculum, domestic and international financing of public education, and global solidarity to the current levels of the inequality. So these are some points which we have really thought and pondered about the post-COVID era, which was important kind of thing. The domestic and international financing of public education is important because the public education is one point which is very close to the heart of, I think, Rama Reddy Saab and all of us also, that it needs a lot of funding at the public education, and we must go on with the kind of public education we have. Next, please. So these are questions, what I thought and I made after the post-COVID kind of a thing. We have demand for online education. We have returned to liberal arts, leapfrogged to Web 17.0 millennium. This is the report. Education programs for the prenatal to that has come into the NEP, new education policy, which we are trying to implement. Just-in-time learning, homeschooling, augmented reality, which is one of the important tool to be the next generation kind of the technology. Teamwork through virtual platforms, predictive analysis, and many more. So these are the predictions which I thought some of the points, but you may be also thinking a lot of many points with the technology, but somewhat I thought at this point of time, I can think about these kind of predictions which we have, demand for online, predictive analysis, we learn from augmented reality, teamwork through the virtual platform, predictive analysis. These are the things. Next, please. So these are the future of learning technologies. In K-12 classroom across the United States, students are visiting for off places such as Machu Picchu, the Great Barrier Reef, and the other location without ever leaving. So this is what is the augmented reality. Educators can access programs such as the Google Expedition Pioneer Program for lessons and additional resources to create virtual field trip experiences. So this is what is the virtual experience in the augmented reality. These are all future of learning technologies. I think we will can also using this Google Expeditions programs or Google Expeditions things or other things, we can also look for the virtual reality. We have come from a cinema and bioscope kind of a thing. Today we are going to have this kind of the virtual reality things. Next. Increased use of games and simulation. This is also a very, very important thing. Although in our country, we said that we can learn from games. So new games and new simulations are coming to give students the experience of working together on a project without leaving their classroom. Students are involved actively in a situation. So we create a situation that we can and must decide what to measure and how to analyze data in order to save a challenging program. This example includes Room Wiki, in which the entire classroom becomes a scaled down simulator of an earthquake. So people can learn with the games and the simulations. So games and simulations are also the next era tools for learning and learning technologies. Next, please. Interactive three-dimensional imaging software, such as Jed Space, is creating potentially transformational learning experience with three-dimensional glass and a stylus. It includes the people to work through a wide range of images from the layers of the earth to a human heart. So we looked about those kind of things, and all of you must also, we have seen the three-dimensional imaging softwares, which is also a new generation kind of thing. Next, please. augmented reality, which we have thought is a new way of investigating our context and history in the cyber learning, transforming educational DXP project. Researchers are addressing how, for what purposes AI technology can be used to support the learning of critical inquiry strategies and processes. So these are the also new kind of things which we have looked for: augmented reality, games and simulations, the field visits, the Google expedition. All these are very, very new technologies. And with the new kind of computations, new kind of AI tools, we are able to deal with all these things. Next, please. So if you look to this kind of a thing, where we will have our collaborators, we can have online classrooms, we have got courses, we have got blockchain. So if you look to these tools, we have got employers. So this is a whole ecosystem which we can look. People are doing group projects, so people are there. So this kind of a new kind of classroom or a new kind of system, maybe they are learning and learning experiences. So we can have a collaboration, a student can have a collaboration with all kind of things. So this is one thing which we really look upon. Next, please. So if you look education platform using an artificial intelligence technology, we have got Third Space Learning, Little Dragon, Brainy, CTI, Carnival Learning, Thinker Maths. So these kind of all things we can really look upon with this new AI technologies at place. Next. So next is teaching with technology. So we will go and discuss something about this also. Next, please. So these are the key points which we really, and I think in the COVID era we have seen. Educators can collaborate far beyond the walls of their schools. Educators can design highly engaging and relevant learning experiences through technology. Educators can lead the evolution and implementation of new technologies for learning. Educators can guide, facilitate, and motivate learners. Educators can get co-learners with students and peers. Educators can become catalysts to serve the undeserved. So these are the important points which we have never seen. And this is what new collaboration between technology is going to happen. My friends, if you use these technologies, I think all of us must have experienced kind of thing in these kind of technologies and in these kind of things. But we are going ahead and to do these things. Next, please. So this is a connected educator. If you look to this kind of things, this is a lifelong learner, views failure of part of learning, comfortable with the new and the aid technology to meet learning needs, grounded in the content and the pedagogy, focused to the creation of the content, sharing the collaboration part of the daily learning. These are the ideas through many connections, use technology to learn and teach. So this is a connected educator. If you look to the new educator, he's a new educator and a new facilitator. He will, or he, she will, she may look like this kind of thing, the educator kind of a thing, which we are seeing and where we can do. Next. So next, please. So this is a, can you go back, please? Yes. So creating a culture and condition for innovation and changes. This is one of the important things. If you look and talk to the young people, I think in this new India and the country which we are seeing today, there is a sharp change among the students for having innovations. They are not still old students. They are not looking for jobs. They are looking for jobs, but they are also looking for innovation and changes. I think this is important. Next, please. So if the key points is technology-enabled personalized pathways for student learning through active and collaborative learning activities, clearly defined set of learning outputs, guide instruction, the outcomes, and the aligned curriculum instruction and assessment reflect the multidisciplinary nature of the knowledge. A robust technology infrastructure is essential, and that's what we are creating, a transformative digital learning environment. And leaders need to take ownership of infrastructure development and maintenance. So we were known, I think the civil engineers are known for highways, and we will be known, the new infrastructure or a new will be known for the e-ways. So there will be e-ways. Earlier, people were known for highways. We will be known for e-ways and the digital infrastructure and with the internet speed and what we can do in a cyberspace. These are all infrastructure, and now people are talking about the digital infrastructure. So we need good, robust networks. We need good kind of clouds. We need good kind of a software just to do this kind of things. Next, please. So this is what is a kind of a the assessment in the next generation. Can you make it slightly broader? I think we can look into those things. So the traditional and kind of things. So if we look to this slide, we look to the timings. So the timings in the traditional way was after learning. The next generation is there in the embedded in learning. Accessibility was very limited. Now the accessibility is universally designed. Pathways were fixed. We go A to B to C. The pathways are adaptive. So we learn, adapt, and then learn. We feedback was delayed. Now we can get a real-time feedback with the technology. Item types were generic. Now we can have got enhanced type of things. So these are the feature of assessment. So they were traditional, the next generation feedback. So we next generation feedback quote is embedded in learning, universally designed, adaptive, real time, and we can have enhanced. Next, please. So enabling access and effective use, all student and educator will have access to a robust, comprehensive infrastructure when and they need for the learning. That's there. That's what is an important kind of a thing which we really look to this kind of thing. Next, please. So if we look to the key points, it is ubiquitous connectivity, persistent access to high-speed internet in and out of school, powerful learning devices, last mile connectivity to the devices, access to mobile devices and connect leaders and educators to the vast resources of the internet and facilitate communication and collaboration, high quality digital learning content, that is important, and responsible to use policies, that is RUPIC's guideline to safeguard students and ensure that the infrastructure is used to support learning. Next point, please. So if we look into the next point, what is there? So if you look, we have got a student which is there. We have got a learning curve. We see in this inner circle, what we have is assessment, then leadership, and then teaching. So that cycle goes. And if we look to this kind of thing, we will have a high-speed connectivity to schools. We have data privacy and security. We have high-speed Wi-Fi throughout schools, high-quality, low-cost computing devices, home internet access, digital citizenship and responsible use, and quality digital content resources. So if you look to this new technology and this kind of a network we can have, and this kind of a network we will see in a very near future in all our universities, in all our schools, in all our learning space and learning co-spaces. I think if I can recap the whole lecture, what I have got. So one important thing is that we have got a disruption and we have to live with the disruption. The disruption in the space of education is there. Second important point, which I thought is important to see, that we have to learn to this new pedagogy. We have to learn and adopt this technology, and the technology will change the whole kind of things. It can change the UGC regulations. It will change how we do learning. It can change, and it will change the kind of learning, because we will have what micro degrees. Our student will learn from different platforms. We have to integrate different platforms learning into one ERP, that is resource ERP kind of a thing. Then we need high kind of infrastructure. We need a new kind of a facilitator or a teacher who himself is a learner, who is fast in technologies, who can create digital contents, who can learn to the fast technologies. We will have gaming, simulations, technologies, new AI tools for learning. And we should have new digital infrastructure in place that people can learn. So it's a new era of creation, collaboration, and making us adaptation for the new technologies. So thank you very much for this patient hearing to all of you. If you have got any questions or any discussions, it's always welcome. But it was a memorable thing to be present in the Rama Reddy's lecture, who is actually father of distance in open learning. And I worked for two consecutive times in Uttarakhand and Kota for this time thing. So thank you very much and for inviting me. Thanks.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks for our immediately accepting our invitation and delivering a very elaborate lecture, which is most suitable to the, not only to the present context, and also to the more dear and to the heart of Professor G. Ram Reddy. Sir, as you know, you have explained in detailed manner, apart from offline, ODL and online learning and teaching, now the technology-based, highly technology-based personalized learning is going to be the become very crucial in future of teaching and learning in, for the next generation. The personalized learning, the concepts of place, time and mode, that is anywhere, anytime, any mode, we are going to shift to that model very with a lot of pace. So in this context, providing access, connection and empowering the learner becomes the very important slogan or whatever you say, mantra of the future educators or educationists in the country. So another important dimension is how to overcome the digital divide in countries like India, where the gap between technology and poor people and also the fast growing nature of technology based education. No doubt people are using smartphones, that the day by day that is increasing number, but their main use is different. Social media and like different kinds of using for games, cinemas and all that. But using them for education, maybe it takes some more time to get themselves aware of how best it can be used for the learning and also for getting more awareness and consciousness. Sir, that anyhow, in the future, we will definitely go to that stage, but we cannot avoid the use and integration of technology in our education. Sir, thank you once again for accepting our invitation and giving us a very interesting and thought-provoking lecture on technology-enabled education in next generation. Sir, now as part of this program, we are also organizing a small event and releasing of books written by our colleague, Professor Vajanam Srinivas, Associate Professor of History Department, and is also in charge of material production division in our university recently has published two books on media and Telangana armed struggle, and also Hyderabad state gleanings from polity, society and culture. These are the two books recently has published, and we are going to release these books on this auspicious occasion. And I request all our guests participating in the online, request them to bless Srinivas to in his career.
Yeah, this is about the media and Telangana armed struggle, the communication media, the role in the Telangana armed struggle. The another book which is going to be released is the Hyderabad State, ruled by the Nizam of Asadjahi period, gleanings from the polity, society and culture.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And congratulations to our Srinivas. And wish you all the best in your career.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Thank
you. Now, the last item on the agenda is proposing formal vote of thanks by Dr. Venugopal Reddy, PRO, Dr. Ambedkar of University.
Dignitaries on the dais and invitees who joined through online and offline. It is my proud privilege to propose formal vote of thanks for today's lecture on Technology-Enabled Education in Next Generation by Professor Vinay Kumar Patakji, Vice Chancellor, CSJMU, Kanpur, organized by the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University and in collaboration with Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust on the occasion of 92nd birthday celebrations of BRAU founder Vice Chancellor, the great Dean of Distance Education, Professor G. Ram Reddy Garu. At the outset, my personal behalf and on behalf of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University, I express my humble thanks to Professor Vinay Kumar Patakji, Vice Chancellor CSJMU, Kanpur, for being the chief guest and keynote speaker to deliver the memorial lecture today. He has expressed his views on future technology and adoption of technology is the need of the hour. Thank you very much, sir, for delivering the lecture. I extend my sincere thanks to our Vice Chancellor, Professor K. Sitarama Rao Garu, Director Academic, Professor E. Sudharani Garu, and Register in Charge, Dr. A.V.N. Reddy Garu of this university for participation and cooperation to conduct the program. I also express my thanks to Professor G. Ram Reddy's family members, particularly Madam Pramila Ram Reddy Garu, and Professor G. Aragopal Garu, Secretary, Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Trust, and members of the trust who joined in this program through online. And also thanks to joining for former Vice Chancellor Professor B.S. Prasad Garu, former Vice Chancellor Krishna University, and former Professor of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University, Professor B. Venkaya Garu, former Register of the University, Professor C. Venkataya Garu, former Academic Directors, Professor S.V. Rajasekhar Reddy Garu, Professor Kiran Mai Garu, and other senior professors who joined this webinar. Last but not least, I convey my sincere thanks to all the directors, deans, heads of the branches, teaching and non-teaching staff members, and representatives of various service associations for today's program, and more particularly, the cooperation of the AVPRC crew members, engineering branch, director academic office staff, vice chancellor's office staff, for extending their cooperation for conducting the memorial lecture in a smooth manner. Once again, I thank you very much for each and everyone. Thank you, one and all.